Hello and welcome to another MBK Design video tutorial. I'm Annika, one of the creative team member from MBK Design. And today we will edit a photo in a little bit of dramatic way. It's called the dither effect in Photoshop. And like most of the photo editing tutorials, it depends on your photo, how it will turn out. And don't be disappointed if it's not like you wish. Try with another photo, try with different settings, and I'm sure you will get some great results. So I start with this photo. It's from the Sumi app, and the size of my photo is 2000 by 2500, resolution 72, but feel free to resize your photo in a size which works for you best. So first, if you have a colored photo, I will turn this into a black and white. And as I told you, it will be a little bit more dramatic. I also bring a little bit more contrast in this photo. Okay, and I will unlock my background, and we need now adjustment layer solid color, and I will start with a warm red background, but we can change this or more brownish, okay, and bring it behind your photo. We can change the color at any time. Now make your background solid color here active and go to the FX and go to pattern overlay. And now we need this erodible textures, which are in Photoshop, but I think they are not in Photoshop CS5. I'm not sure. So load this, append, and you have this textures here, and you can use the pastel paper or a fine grain or the pebbled board. So I will start with pastel paper and don't care at the moment about the settings. Just click OK and then make your photo layer active, and we need another adjustment layer levels. And clip the levels adjustment layer to your photo by clicking this little icon here. Don't care about the settings too at the moment, we will edit this later. Now make your photo layer active and change the blend mode to hard mix. And now we take care of the settings. So double click on your levels adjustment layer and now move the sliders until you are happy with the result. So it's always something you have to try, and every photo will turn out different. So I like this. And now if you click here, double click on this pattern overlay, your layer style window opens. And now we can also change our settings for the overlay. Again, try what looks best for you. And I think this is okay. And that's it. Simple, easy, and fast. And you can achieve a very dramatic photo editing. And now, if you want, you can double click on this, on your color here, and you can change the colors and try. This also looks nice. And if you make your photo layer again active and go to filter and filter gallery, and go to the artistic folder and click film grain, you can add this too if you want. That's all in this tutorial. I hope you had fun and get another inspiration how you can edit your photos, and to see you next time. Bye.